I keep seeing these videos go viral about the new Huawei Mate 70 Pro, where you can simply grab a photo out of the air with your hand and then magically put it on another Huawei device without ever touching either phone. And people are saying in the comments, oh, the iPhone is cooked, Apple would never, blah, blah, blah. So I'm gonna show you some magic tricks you can do with Apple devices, like transferring an image. All right, let's do a trick of our own. I'll take this, it's now in my hand, send it over here. Amazing. So I'll show you how I did that in a second. It's using accessibility plus shortcuts. But first, on Huawei's page for the Mate 70 Pro, they're calling it AI transmission, where you can grab this image and then send it over to another device. Unclear what exactly this is, whether it needs to be on the same account. There is a footnote down here saying it requires an upgrade. Only the Mate 70 series phones can do this. And it looks like there's lots of other requirements. So unclear exactly what Huawei is doing, but if you're just looking to send an image to another Apple device quickly, there's actually even better ways than that. So first, let me explain what I was doing between my iPhone and iPad. You'll see I have this image here in the note, and what I was wanting to do was copy something to my clipboard, and then using Universal Clipboard, which is across all Apple devices, paste it over here. But unfortunately, there's no paste action in shortcuts. So if you go to create a new shortcut and then look for clipboard, there's get clipboard and copy to clipboard, but no paste from clipboard. So you can't paste something somewhere without any physical interaction. So what I did was create two shortcuts. The first one is the I can grab it shortcut, where it takes a screenshot of the image, it cropped it to that square, and then copied the image to my clipboard. Now once it's on your clipboard, Universal Clipboard means that you can paste it anywhere, and I could just tap paste over here on my iPad and it would send the image, but then I would have to touch the screen. So the other shortcut I created was the send it over here shortcut, which allows me to get the clipboard, and then what I did was append what was on the clipboard to this specific note. So it wouldn't work in all the applications. But in order to achieve this without ever touching the devices, I had to use something called vocal shortcuts. If you go to settings and accessibility, then scroll most of the way down, you'll see vocal shortcuts is an option here. When you enable vocal shortcuts, you can program certain phrases that will trigger even if you don't touch the voice assistant button, and you really have to have no physical interaction with your device. So I have a few shortcuts here just to kind of show you what it looks like, but I can say this phrase, which you program by adding an action, and this you can choose any of the shortcuts that you have built. And so I just have simple ones here like to lock screen. So I could say lock my phone screen, and you'll see it did it without me ever touching the phone. Or I can say toggle unknown callers. And I can even toggle my unknown callers just by saying that phrase, never touching the phone. Now, when you have vocal shortcuts enabled, you'll notice that the microphone orange dot that appears up here is always gonna be on. That's because it has to be listening constantly to know when you say these phrases. So that is a caveat. It's probably gonna affect battery life, but if you wanna say some things to your devices without ever actually touching it, you can use it with vocal shortcuts. This is also on the Mac. So if you want to use this and not worry about battery life, you can set up vocal shortcuts right here on the Mac and just say things to your computer and it'll do stuff. But let's go back to the Huawei gimmick. If you really wanted to send an image to another iPhone, the best way to do it is actually AirDrop. But I also know AirDrop can be finicky sometimes. So if you're in the share sheet for something like an image, this would also work for links, you can actually hold the top of two iPhones together and rather do name drop, which is typically what happens when you tap the two iPhones together, it will actually automatically AirDrop what you had on screen during the share sheet, and then the other device can accept or decline. Which, by the way, that image I just sent is the podcast artwork for my tech show with Jason Aten, Primary Tech. You should subscribe, link above and down in the description. This also works if you're on a website and then you hit the share button, just hold the top of the two phones together, you'll see the little animation, and then it will share that link rather than the typical name drop. Now, if you don't have the share sheet open and you hold two iPhones together, then it's gonna do name drop, where you're sharing your contact information with another device. But if you're on a note, a shortcut, or anything where you have that share sheet open, just hold the devices together, wait for the little animation, and it's gonna share that link, that note, that image that you had on screen. It could even work with something like a podcast, have the share sheet up, hold your phones together, and when the other person accepts it, they'll get brought to the podcast app. Now, of course, you don't have to bring your devices together and AirDrop will work as long as you're near someone. And the recipient does have to accept the AirDrop, which also seems like a security thing with the Huawei if you can just do that with your hand and it appears on your phone. But you can also create another shortcut to get to AirDrop even faster. So for this shortcut, we're gonna choose the action, get what's on screen. And then for our second action, we're gonna say AirDrop. Now, if you wanna just download this shortcut in the video description, you can do that. Plus links to my shortcuts playlist are down there with lots of other shortcuts and automations. This is going to airdrop what's on screen when we tap the action button. Now I'm going to go back to the settings app. Let's put this on our action button. We'll choose the airdrop action button. So now if we're looking at a website and I hold the action button, it's going to get what's on screen, which is actually a website. I'm going to tap allow, and then you'll see the share sheet come up. I can go to airdrop. That's going to airdrop the URL to another person. They accept and they go to the website. This will also work if I'm looking at an image. So here I have an image here. This is actually from Byte Review. I'll put a link to their wallpapers in the description. If I hold the action button, it's going to get what's on screen. I'll tell it to allow, and then it goes to the share sheet, airdrop, send it to somebody. And now it's going to send that image in an airdrop to the recipient. Now remember, you can also expedite this process. So if you hold the action button, it automatically opens the share sheet. Don't tap anything. Just hold your phone to another device. You'll see that animation appear, and then we'll automatically trigger the airdrop. There's the image, and now it's on the other device. So that's vocal shortcuts and expediting the airdrop process, but there's some other really cool magic tricks. For instance, let's go back into the settings. We'll go down to accessibility, and one of the recent additions to iOS is actually eye tracking. With eye tracking enabled, you can actually use your eyes to select things on screen. Once you enable it, you do have to go through a programming process where you follow dots on screen, and the front-facing camera is actually going to program that and make sure that it's tracking properly. But even if you don't use the eye tracking part specifically, which you can actually also put in the control center, I actually have a page down here where I started putting some accessibility features, and I can turn eye tracking on or off right here from the control center. But one of the other cool features that only works when eye tracking is enabled is if I go to assistive touch and scroll all the way down to where it says sound actions, these are actually sounds that you can make with your mouth, and then it will actually control your iPhone. You can practice the sounds, and this can help you trigger the sound. So E, and you'll see that was highlighted. I can go K, and there's that highlighted, or popping with my mouth makes that sound. And once you know what sounds actually are triggered, then you can customize things, even like a shh. And here you can pair system actions to that sound or accessibility features and also scroll gestures. And you can see the microphone actually enabled. Now let's say you were in a scrolling app and now I can make the sound shh, shh, and I can actually scroll just making those sounds. Now having eye tracking on for that can be a little cumbersome, but you can also go into the voice control section of accessibility, enabling voice control, and then going down to commands, you'll see all the many options for things like scrolling and even exactly what to say, like scroll down. So now even with eye tracking off, if I go back to YouTube, scroll down, and you can control it just using your voice. Also, third-party apps can take advantage of things like eye tracking, winking, and blinking. And one of my favorite examples is the Fourscore app on the iPad. Me and my wife both use it for digital sheet music, and you can literally turn the page by blinking, moving your head, or just your mouth. And so if you don't have a pedal to turn pages and you're playing an instrument so you don't have your hands, that winking feature is super cool. If you want to see those blinking controls in action with the Fourscore app, check out my video on the iPad apps right here. Now, another cool magic trick in accessibility is control nearby devices. So let's say you have one device near you, but another device is out of reach. You can select nearby devices right here in accessibility, and you have a bunch of controls like going home. I can go to my task switcher. I can open Control Center right here for my iPhone. And there's other options here like to control playback, enable the voice assistant, and more. All right, and one other cool accessibility feature, I actually recently watched the movie Out of My Mind. It's on Disney Plus, and it follows the story of a child with cerebral palsy. Well, in the movie, the parents try to get a $17,000 device. This way they are able to have a voice and can speak by tapping words or phrases on this pad. It's kind of wild because the movie is set in like 2003, which is way before the iPhone and iPad. And this same conflict about the price of the device probably wouldn't work today because Apple devices have this feature built in. If you go back to accessibility and if you scroll down, you'll actually see live speech here. And if you enable live speech, this can also be a shortcut when you triple click the side button. You can then have your device speak out loud everything you type almost in real time. So I can enable live speech. I'll type down here and I'll just hit speak.
Hey, how are you today?
And instead of a keyboard, you can also tap here and have recent phrases. You can add phrases down here to have them at the ready.
Testing out speaking.
You can also go to a saved folder where you can save phrases you use commonly and even categorize multiple phrases. This way you can have an entire bank of phrases, words, questions, all saved in here, and your device can speak it for you. So those are just a few magic tricks for your Apple devices. And if you really get into shortcuts, you can do incredible things with automations. based on location, things for your action button. And if that interests you, you should definitely subscribe to the channel because I have lots of shortcut videos. I'll actually put an entire playlist right up here. I actually take requests from you and the community, which you can go to create.beard.fm. You can join the community for free, talk to other shortcuts and automation lovers. And if you support the community at $5 a month, you actually get access to my entire shortcuts database, which you can search or browse by device. And I prioritize these shortcuts requests that are left there in the community. So that's create.beard.fm to join my shortcuts community, or just watch all the videos right here on the channel if you'd like to learn more. I even have a shortcuts 101 and 201 video that goes over the basics starting from scratch. And if you want to watch that, check it out right up here. Hit that like button before you go. If you have any shortcuts requests or accessibility questions, leave comments below this video. I'll answer you personally. And thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.